Amazing, isn't it? It's amazing how so often we think the whole world revolves around us. We sometimes only see what is right in front of us. Just as the video shows, we are part of a much bigger, bigger picture. So, wondering what this whole Palm Sunday is about? Well, there is a bigger God story. Let's get started. If you have your worship candle ready, let's ask an adult to help us light it. If you are at church, if our acolyte can go up and light our worship candle now. As we light it, let's let the light of Christ open up our hearts so that we can hear and respond to God. Together, let's say John chapter 8, verse 12. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. John chapter 8, verse 12. Let's pray. Jesus, Savior of the world, Savior of my life, thank you for calling us together to worship you. This morning, we celebrate your triumphal entry. We remember your entry into Jerusalem on Passover week, just as the people who saw your miracles and heard your teachings and hoped for the Savior came to welcome you as King. We celebrate and worship you as the God who saves. Holy Spirit, open our eyes and hearts as we worship and hear your word so that we might have faith in the one and only Son of God, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen, everybody. For those of you who are joining us online, we just returned from doing the Palm Sunday parade upstairs in the main sanctuary. Can you all guess why today is called Palm Sunday? Yep, because of these palms. Palms that were used to cheer and celebrate Jesus. These palms are just a small piece of the larger picture. So let's get started. Use our palms as we celebrate and worship God.
I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Forever you reign, here and now, hear the sound. away from searching for lesser glory. Turn my eyes and teach my
words that we just sang to God. There is none more beautiful, there is none more powerful than Jesus. Center my life on your name. That is another way to say our life application for this month. Let's read it together. Hope, believing that something good can come out of something bad. Maybe you spent the week sick. Maybe things are not going well at school. Maybe you are having a hard time because you just moved. Whatever you might be going through, let's remember our monthly Bible verse. In this world, you will have trouble, but be encouraged. I have won the battle over the world. John chapter 16, verse 33b. Remember, right now, we only have a few small pieces of the puzzle, but we can have hope when we believe that God sees the bigger picture. Today, even if things are hard and tough, let's remember today's bottom line. Whatever happens, remember, God is still working. This means don't give up. Don't lose faith. Keep going no matter what the challenge might be. So, speaking of challenge, let's play a game. I'll give you a series of challenges with just 20 seconds each. You have to complete one challenge and then move on to the next one. Can we do it? Here we go. It's a riddle. Do 10 of these and you'll move on with ease. Just clap way up top while both your feet do a hop. Go. All do 10 jumping jacks? That's what it was. Challenge number two. Can you solve this puzzle? If you know, raise your hands and shout it out. Was your answer, I believe in you? I do. I think we might just complete the challenge. Challenge number three, fill in the blanks. Maybe I'll give some more common letters. You have 10 seconds left. Home sweet home. Yes, it is. Challenge number four. If you look at these words, you'll see where we will head next. Do you see any hidden words? Passover, announcement, little donkey, Messiah. Find the hidden word. If you guessed palm, it's time for today's Bible story from John chapter 12, verses 9 to 16. When Jesus raised his friend Lazarus from the dead, news spread quickly. Many people believed in Jesus, and the religious leaders, well, they flew into a rage.
If we let Jesus keep doing this, everyone will believe in him.
He'll cause so much trouble, the Romans will come in and take over.
So, it's decided. We will remove him.
For a time, Jesus went away to a nearby village of Ephraim. As the Passover feast was near, the people of Jerusalem began to look for him.
Isn't he coming to the feast?
He'd be a fool. The Pharisees have given orders to arrest him.
Jesus wasn't threatened by the religious leaders. He was following the plans that God had set in motion long before. Along with his disciples, Jesus returned to the town of Bethany. From there, he made plans to enter Jerusalem. He told two of his disciples,
"Go to the village ahead of you. As soon as you get there, you will find a donkey tied up. Her colt will be with her."
"Village, check. Donkey, check. Colt, check."
"Untie them and bring them to me."
"Untie... Wait, what?
We can't just go taking someone's donkeys."
"Anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them."
"The Lord needs them. Check."
"And the owner will send the donkeys right away."
"We're on it."
The disciples entered the town just as Jesus had instructed them.
"Well, there they are.
And now we will just calmly untie them like we walk off every day with donkeys that don't belong to us." "No biggie."
"Hey, those are my donkeys."
The Lord needs them."
Well, in that case, just remember the big one kicks real bad. And she likes figs."
Jesus' disciples brought the donkey to him and laid the coats across the colt's back for Jesus to sit on.
"He's walked a gazillion miles. Why does he want to ride a donkey now?"
Jesus wasn't too tired to walk. He was carrying out the plan that God has put into motion hundreds of years earlier when the prophet Zechariah said,
"Say to the city of Zion, see, your king comes to you. He is gentle and riding on a donkey."
Now Jesus was showing everyone that he was the king that God had promised. As he rode toward Jerusalem, the excitement went through the crowds of travelers. They threw their coats down on the ground, making a pathway, and others threw large branches off the nearby palm trees, laying them across the road and waving them high in the air.
"Hosanna!
Oh, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord."
Some people ran ahead of Jesus and others streamed behind in a joyful, glorious parade.
"Hosanna!
Hosanna!
Hosanna!
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord!"
A As the procession neared the city, people ran out to see what was happening.
Who is this?
This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth.
Yeah, he brought Lazarus back from the dead.
In all the excitement, one group of people was not pleased. The religious leaders.
This isn't getting us anywhere. Look how the whole world is following him.
Don't worry. I've got a plan.
A plan?
To remove Jesus.
Oh, right. The air quote.
He won't last the week.
But God was still at work, and nothing that anyone could do would stop God's plan to save the world. Remember at the beginning of our worship, I said that the palm was just a small piece of the puzzle to a bigger story? You see, the people who came to welcome Jesus into Jerusalem also only saw a small part of God's bigger story. They saw all that Jesus did. They saw all the miracles that he performed, like the healing of the blind, the paralyzed, churning water into wine, the feeding of the 5,000, and raising Lazarus from the dead. They heard all the amazing things Jesus taught, and they believed that Jesus was the promised Messiah who would save them from the Roman Empire. But we know that God's story of salvation is so much bigger and greater. See this palm? Many of the Jewish people thought that Jesus coming into Jerusalem was to fight the Romans. But in olden times, palms like this represented not only victory, but also peace. Just like the colt donkey that Jesus rode on was a sign of peace. Jesus entered Jerusalem to carry out God's plan of peace, making peace with God. Today, the palms remind us what price Jesus paid for this peace. This is a cross that was made with the palm frond. You see, just a few days later, the excitement and celebration of Palm Sunday will be turned into disbelief, sadness, and confusion when their king and savior is arrested, beaten, and nailed to the cross. But wait! The story doesn't end here. So let's remember that whatever happens, remember, God is still working. This week is called Passion Week. It is a week where we see God's love poured out for us. We get to see God's bigger picture, that God keeps his promises and that Jesus is not only the savior that the Jewish people were waiting for, but that Jesus came to save everyone. Palms to the cross this week. How will you worship God? Let's pray. Hosanna, please save. Thank you, Jesus, that there is a bigger story than the one that we see before us. Thank you, God, for sending us our Savior, Jesus. Help us remember both the palms and the cross this week. Thank you for dying on the cross for us so that we can have peace with God and one another. Even as the world around us is hurting and broken, help us to put our hope in you and that you are making all things new. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. So much to thank God for today, isn't there? Even if we are going through some hard time, right? Let's offer up to God our gifts and offering. If you are at home, you can lift it up to God like this and bring in your offering when you return to your church. If you are at church, you can line up quietly now and put your offering into the offering basket. Together, let's sing the doxology as our offering prayer.
Praise God from whom our blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy. Praise Him above the heavenly hosts.
close with the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Have a blessed Zoom or in-person Sunday school, everyone. Hosanna!